This episode was made possible by Squarespace. Build a professional website for your brand today. A very good day, my name is Benny and welcome to this brand new episode of Realistified, the show in which I turn your drawings into sort of reality using Photoshop. You guys really seem to enjoy these and, well, so do I, so hereby the third episode. If you want to see your drawing in the next episode, all you gotta do is send it to bennysedit show@gmail.com. Now, let's not waste any more time and get straight into the first drawing of today, which was made by Stein. I watched your Realistify show on YouTube and was hoping you could do this on your next episode. Thank you, Stein, for your submission. This is a very cool drawing in my opinion, and I'm pretty sure this could look really badass when turned realistic, so let's just start right away. So here we are for the first drawing for today, and for the body I'm just gonna go and take this snake body I found right here. There you go. I've got another one right here. These two I'm going to use to recreate his body, and first I'm just gonna take this, make it a little bigger, and I'm going to use warp to get it as close as possible, and this a bit to the right. There you go. That should be pretty close. That is the main thing. Then I'm gonna add a layer mask to remove it from this area right here. There you go. Then I'm gonna take this one again, put it right there, and then use warp again. There you go. Then I'm going to add a layer mask, sort of draw that round shape it has right here, just like that. Make that thing a little bigger. That looks pretty nice. Then it goes on right down here. So for that I'm going to use this one. Then again, warp like that. There you go. That should be pretty close. And again, add a layer mask. And then finally that tail end kind of thing right there. So that is pretty much the main body, I'd say. Now we have to start working on the head. So for that I am going to trace the shape of its head. I'm just gonna go over it with my pen tool again. There you go. That's pretty sweet. Now I'm going to fill this shape with a texture, and I found this reptile skin texture, which I'm going to just put on there. And then guess what? I'm gonna use warp yet again to sort of get the shape of the texture right. So you know, it actually looks a bit roundish. So right now I think it's best to first give him the right color, because obviously he's not black in the original drawing. So I'm going to make him dark blue, since the original drawing had him a lightish blue, but I think dark blue would be pretty cool too. So I'm going to do that. Let me see, with maybe color balance, probably also be a little brighter. That's better. Then the body itself should also be that same color. There you go. Then I think it would be best if we start adding some lighting. So for that I'm just gonna go and add adjustment layers like this one, for example, which brightens the head on top. And then the same thing with a shadow right here. So I'm just gonna go with a brush, and actually this is pretty good already. And a bit right down here. And that exact same thing I'm gonna have to do with the rest of his body. So I'm just gonna go up here and add that highlight. There you go. Some of you may notice that this is basically the exact same thing as I did with the aquatic dragon from the first episode, except the values are all different, of course, but basically this is the exact same thing. And then that same highlight except a shadow, so it's the opposite. And there you go, that really does add something. That's really cool, actually. So the next thing I'm going to do, his face needs some of those details and wrinkles and stuff, because the original, as you can see, has that. I'm gonna draw these little lines right there. There you go. That's pretty nice. And I'll also add some detail right up here. There you go. So then, you know what, I'm just gonna put that hat on there already, because I really like that. Make that a little bigger. There you go. Put it on his head. There you go. This is gonna be so freaking cool, dude. That should be a bit darker though. The little highlight on the right. And the bottom should be darker. Then I do have to remove the highlight from the head again right here, because, well, the hat is in the way. And add a shadow right here instead of a highlight. There you go. That's pretty cool. Wow, that is pretty cool. The original one has this purple line all the way down on his body, and that's a pretty big thing, so I'm gonna have to do something for that. I think first I'm just gonna try to make him purple and try to paint on the desired area. I'm not gonna do it exactly as the original, because this isn't technically accurate in comparison with the body shape mine has. So I'm just going to sort of do my own sort of thing. And some of the skills are supposed to be the border between pink and not pink, like this. Now this looks a bit strange. So in order to fix that, I'm going to add a brightness and contrast layer, copy that previous mask and make it a bit brighter. That really does something. Maybe levels would be better. There, that is better. And decrease the opacity of the color layer. There you go, that's pretty cool. First just very rough to see if it's the right place. I think it is. There you go. And then copy this mask to the previous There you go.
Very cool.
For the inside of the mouth, I thought maybe we could just use the inside of a reptile's mouth right here. So I'm gonna put that up here and then use warp again to sort of try to make this look all right. There you go. I think that's fine for now. And go to liquify to finalize the shape. Oh, wow. And then I'm going to add a layer mask to, guess what? Remove everything that should not be visible. So the entire inside. There you go. Now that thing should be really dark and really barely visible because it is the inside and there's barely any light in there. Now I'm going to do the eyes because I just simply cannot wait. I'm going to drop in my eye. Here you go. Super cool creepy eye. We've got one right here and we've got one right there. Then I'm gonna use this thing to hopefully create that eye socket that the original has, because I don't really know how else to do that. Let's sort of merge it together with the original skin. That thing should be a whole lot darker. I guess that is some sort of... No! And a shadow on the eye itself. That for sure is sinister. Well, let's do that to the other eye too. Then I'm going to remove these little things because he needs crosses in his eyes like the original. And that's exactly what I'm going to do. And then I'm gonna put in these crosses like this. There you go. Now that is a lot more like it. Yep. Then for the nose, I'm just gonna trace the shape really quick to make sure it's the exact same shape. Then I'm going to fill that with a texture. There you go. Beautiful. Which I'm going to add warp to, because guess what? It's supposed to look like it's actually on there. Then I'm going to make that yellow because the original is yellow too. And then add some shadows to it. First one right here and the shadow below it, just like that. Then I guess that's the nose. Then for the tongue, I've got this image, which is a cat tongue. I mean, obviously because of those little spikes. And that one I'm just going to put in there. Wow, that's beautiful. So this is supposed to become this this sort of shape. Then again, use warp. It's just 90% warp here. It's crazy. Try and make this. That was a little easier than I thought, actually. That is disgusting. Then I have to put that inside his mouth, which is going to be tricky. Just make it nice and round. There you go. That's a bit better. Now that thing needs to be inside of his mouth. So let's see. I'm gonna go and take a brush, remove it first, and then paint some back. Probably not the best way to do it, but if it works, it works. Then that thing needs some shadows, obviously, just around the edge right there, maybe like that, and a very dark one right down here. And then inside the mouth should be another shadow too. There you go. That's pretty cool. And then finally I can just drop in some teeth. I'm not gonna make them all wavy because I don't know, I just don't really like that. Then put them in the right place. Finally some shadows. Then I guess that is pretty much it. So I'm going to add a quick background and see how that looks. Now that looks really, really freaking cool. So I made two versions, one with and one without the lightning, because like, I like it, but also not. So I just made two versions, whichever you prefer. And yeah, so I guess then that was it for this first one. Let's go on to the next one. Big thanks to Stein for sending your drawing. I could not have done this without you. I'll make sure to send this back to you as soon as I get the chance. Now, before moving on to the next drawing, let me ask you this. What do you see here? Well, exactly, it's Squarespace. Get it? Squarespace? I'll just stop talking now. Squarespace is a fantastic place to create professional looking websites for your brand. Whether you're running a clothing web store or are a designer like me who needs a portfolio, Squarespace has it for you. I mean, look at this. I'm not even kidding, I spent no more than 30 minutes on this. And that's exactly the great thing. It's extremely user friendly. And if you don't have much inspiration, you can just choose one of their templates to start with and you'll be up and running in no time. With tons of great features, the possibility possibilities just don't end. There are social media pairing options, blogging tools to share and schedule photos, videos and updates. There's email campaigns which turn your emails into absolute art. There's donation and payments options with PayPal, Apple Pay, Stripe and Venmo. Make an appointment schedule for people to see your availability and make, well, appointments. And all that comes with full analytics of your website, giving you detailed insight over your website traffic and audience. In short, it's accessible, professional and easy to use. To help you out for a good start, visit squarespace.com for a free trial, and once you feel ready to go big, go to squarespace.com/BennyProductions and save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. You can find the links on top in the description below. Huge thanks to Squarespace for sponsoring this video, it's honestly highly appreciated. Now let's move on to the second drawing for today, which was made by Rodrigo. Hey Benny, I have a challenge for you. I drew this. It's my depiction of the Grim Reaper. He's kinda like a dragon-like creature and has some particles of smoke around him. Those smoke particles are actually spirits. Good luck trying to make this realistic. Thanks Rodrigo for your submission. Let's just do this. So there you go, this is the second image and I removed some stuff to make sure it doesn't distract me. I'm going to start with the skull. I'm just gonna use this real skull for that. How the heck am I gonna do this? You know what, let's first just trace the shape again. And there you go. That right there is the head. I'm going to put this texture inside of it like that. And use some warp to kind of adjust the shape again. And now I'm just gonna try and see how far I get with only shadows and highlights. I think I could probably get pretty far. I'm just gonna start right up here and right here, around the edge right here. I guess that is something already. Then I'm gonna add another shadow. Just a really big and strong one. There you go. Actually, let's also draw the eyes first. There you go. That's better. So now I can add my shadows to these areas too. There you go. See, now it's starting to get some shape. And then I think I could also just add a highlight just like that. Then the insides of the eyes should be pretty black. First, I'll just draw that black. Then I'll just sort of draw those edges. There you go. Now these should be a whole lot darker. That's pretty cool. Then to give this thing some life, I'm going to add this texture to make it a little cracky. Then he has two of those really big scars right on his eye. So I'm going to have to make those two. First, I'm just gonna draw them. And then maybe I can just do bevel and emboss as if it actually goes in the skull. There you go. Look at that. Then before I'm gonna add these horns, I think it's best to start making the body first, because that is the hardest thing, I guess. So for that, I found this bear, because I just assumed that this was fur because of these little things. But I thought just fur, it's way too cute. So I thought wet fur is way better. That really does look some kind of scary. I'm definitely gonna make that black, because that's even worse. But first, I'm gonna try to put this in the right position. And guess what? Use some warp again, of course. Gonna bring that right down there. Gonna push that down. Now this will probably look really weird at the back right here, but that's fine, because we can just use this image over and over again until it looks just the way I want it to look. I want to see it right here, and then here it should stop, because this is where it starts to look weird. So I'm gonna have to use it again and stitch it together. So first I'm gonna try to make it blackish. There you go. Oh, this is gonna be so terrifying. So I'm gonna take this image again, and then again use warp. You know what I think? This actually might just work. Huh, could have been weirder. Then again, layer mask, and just body part by body part, we're just gonna fill in this entire body just like that. So here I've got most of the body as one thing, except for the tail. But since the lower portion of his body is a snake-ish body, I'm just gonna make the tail snake-ish too, because that seems like a great idea. Anyway, now I'm going to add some shadows to the whole thing, because it looks a bit weird and well, not really accurate 3D. So I'm going to do that. Some exposure, make it darker, and then some right down here. Then a highlight on some areas to make sure the light's coming from one side instead of 10. Now that is a little better already. Just these really dark shadows like that. It's pretty horrifying. Then for the lower portion of his body, this, I'm just gonna use the same image that I used for the previous one. This one, very beautiful, because I think that actually might just fit. And then I'm again going to use some warp to get it in the right place. I'm going to draw the parts that I want right until there. And then for the second part, right here. Now this is not looking great, so for that I'm going to add some shadows again. And for the tail end, just the same thing, except I'm gonna make it pointy and draw it back. Then erase some of this stuff, and there you go, that is the tail. Then I'm going to add these horns right here. So for that I found a horn, this one right here. I'm gonna put those on there, but first I'm gonna have to make sure that the colors of the horn and the skull match. So I think I'm gonna make the skull just a little reddish, yellowish. I think that would look a bit more natural. There you go. That looks a bit better. And then I need to match that horn with that same sort of color. The first one is gonna be right here. And before doing anything else, I'm first just gonna try to match the shape with the original horn. There you go. Then add a layer mask and chop off the pointy area. And then copy it. And then the last time for the little one. And then the exact same story on the other side. Then these have to actually look realistic. So I'm going to put, first of all, those three behind the skull. Then I'm gonna add some highlights. These need to be, like, actually inside the fur. So I'm gonna try to... There you go. That's better. And they all need to be generally darker. So first I'm gonna do that, just like that. And then they all need a shadow. There you go. And the last one right there. That looks pretty decent, I'd say. I changed the background color really quick to see what we're dealing with better. Next, I think it's time to add those little spikes on his back right there. So for that, I'm just gonna use this regular sort of bone image that I found. Make it a little smaller. Remove some area. There you go. Now, I think this might actually look pretty cool. And right here on his back. So I've got them all in place right here, and right now I'm gonna have to blend all of these together, and that is gonna be a lot of work. So I'm gonna start with the front one here. First, I gotta make sure the color matches with the rest of his bones. There you go, that's better. Then I'll have to use that fur brush again to sort of try and make it look like it's inside the fur. Then I'll add a shadow to that to make it look like it's inside of it. Probably also add a shadow to this part of the body. And then I think that is pretty much it. That's what I'm gonna have to do to every single one of them. This took a whole lot longer than I thought it would take, but at least it looks pretty cool. So right now there's only one thing left, the arms. And for those, I found some images of bones and hands, and those I'm just going to drop in. So I've got this bone right here for the lower arms. Then I've got this fat one right here, and I've got these two hands. So I'm just going to put first, I'm gonna put these hands in place. I'm gonna make those hands a little different than the original one, because I just didn't really want to have to make those hands individually, because I'm really lazy sometimes. The right arm I am gonna replace, because as you can see, this is the attachment point, so the other one should be here instead of right there. So I'm going to put mine here as well. However, the lower arm can still be the same. So this arm right here, I can put behind the monster. There you go. And now I'm gonna have to make these look good. Same thing as before. First, I'm going to color correct these separate parts. Then this one should just disappear in the fur again. Then let's add a shadow to that one. Shadow to this one too. And then that I'm gonna have to do to the second arm too. So I'm just going to do that really quick. And there you go. That is pretty much the entire thing, I'd say. So now I'm gonna try and add a quick background to see how that looks, and then I'll see you in a second. And there you go, that is the final one. In this case, I made two versions because I don't know, I just feel like this is not its full potential, so I made just a regular version with a very clean background and no weird stuff happening anywhere, just because I just don't really feel like this is it. Too bad I didn't add those little ghosts, but if I did, then this video would be like half an hour. So that's it for this one. Thanks again to Rodrigo for sending your drawing. I'll make sure to send this back to you once I get the chance. Now, from now on, I'm gonna do the third drawing as a speed art type segment instead of talking life. The reason for that is sometimes these things are just quite complicated and especially long to record like that. Also, it kinda reduces the quality because I have to do multiple things at the same time, and it's just a little too intensive. So hereby, the speed art drawing of today. This one was sent by Cohen. Hey Benny, been a long time fan. I was wondering if you could do my drawing. It's not finished fully though, you can add some things if you like. Thanks, Cohen. Thank you, Cohen. I'm pretty sure this might actually work. So let's go and edit this one. We'll be right back. Alright guys, this is why you should never do drugs. This is definitely an interesting thing. I'm dead sure I never would have ever made this if not for this drawing. So that's, well, thanks. I'll make sure to send this back to you when I can. Then I guess that's it. These are the drawings I realistified today. Let me know what your favorite is in the comments below. I'm definitely all for the first one, and honestly I think this is my favorite realistified drawing I did so far. Anyway, if you want to see your drawing in the next video, don't forget to send it to bennyseditshow@gmail.com. And just to be clear, that is not my business email that you can find on my channel. Then, that's it for this week's video. If you liked it, make sure to leave a like and a comment. And if you enjoy my overall content, feel very free to subscribe. And most importantly, destroy that bell to make sure not to miss any future videos. Then I hope I'll see you in my next video.